Sometimes we're insecure, we're fragile. Sometimes we laugh at each other to make ourselves feel better. Sometimes we lie, sometimes we say things that we really don't mean, but in the moment seem like the thing to do. We're all flawed, beautiful people. We're all flawed, beautiful creatures.
What's up, you guys? We are back. We are back with season two of The Healing Couch, and we are so excited. You guys can still catch us on The Healing Couch's YouTube, but y'all can also get in with us on Basic
Media. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on all of our videos that you see as well on our YouTube for The Healing Couch and Basic Media as well.
And hit that bell. Hit that bell because we will be posting every Sunday for you guys. But today, this pandemic, y'all. This pandemic, coronavirus.
It's getting real.
It's getting real.
Shit is getting real.
I think the realest thing for me has been, it's just forced me to sit down. Like, to sit down and look at myself in the mirror, look at the progress that I've made or that I have not made, and really face the reality of like why I haven't made that progress, what I'm going to do differently to make the progress. And it's kind of also made my anxiety on 10. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. Like, it's been crazy. It's been crazy for me.
I agree. But as well, not only crazy, but this time has allowed me personally to reflect on the things that I can do after all of this stuff is over. You know what I mean? So, like, I realized, you know, in the beginning, yeah, everybody was scared. You're losing your job. You don't know how you're going to pay your bills, whatever. We're all figuring it out. And in some situations, you know, the assistance of apartments or whatever, it is helping to a certain extent. Yeah. But it is giving you the time that we are probably not going to get almost ever again as adults or parents or whatever. Yeah, and to say, this is what I need to do to better myself. Now, if you ain't doing that, I don't know what you're doing. Yeah. But I personally have, you know, been making lists of what I need to do, what I want to do, my aspirations, what I want to see for my son, what I want to see for me in the next year. And it's really, as much as stressful as it's been very humbling because I don't ever get that time to just sit and think, what am I going to be doing next?
And that's dope because for me, honestly, like when this first happened, y'all, I was like, I'm out of a job. I don't have to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. Like, and it was frustrating and it was scary. But at the same time, I was like, I need it this time. Like, I feel like there's been a lot of people who are like, I just needed this time to sit down, like to not focus on everything else, not, you know, have my brain going to a million different things in one day of the things I did not accomplish and stressing over those things. Like, I needed that time. But then I felt like when you get on social media, I felt bad for having that time because everybody's like, if you ain't starting a new business during this time, what are you doing? And it's like,
everybody too worried about what everybody else is doing anyways.
It's so annoying. It's like, let me process this how I'm processing it. And now, yes, although like we're coming back with The Healing Couch and like I have other things in the works, it has also like kind of forced me to really look at myself and be like, dang, there are some things that I don't like about myself, which is kind of crazy. Like, not only did it force me to look at the things that I have not accomplished personally, career-wise, or as a mom, but it's also made me be like, dang, I get really emotional about some things and I don't like that. Or dang, like, I allow my anxiety sometimes to take control and I don't like that. Mm-hmm. Or I stress about things that I have no control of and I don't like that. And I feel like this time has really, like, kind of forced me to be like, no, you don't have anything else to do. So look at yourself in the mirror. You can't be around anyone else, although I'll be at Perry's house, y'all. You can't be around anyone else. You can't you don't have this job to focus on or your clients to focus on. So now you need to focus on yourself and deal with the things within you. And it's been a battle. It's been a battle of like, no, I'm going to find anything I can do not to look at like those inner demons. But for real, like the demons were like, just like, running out of the closet during this time. I don't know.
So let's speak on the positive and then get to the negative. So we yes. can, so what in this time do you feel positively that you have done in the last 3 months that you don't think that you were able to do if you didn't have this time?
The time I get to spend with my daughter is crazy. Like, that is awesome. Yes. I love the one-on-one time that we get to have. I love, like, the time we get to just go outside and ride around with her on her bike or, like, play pretend with her dolls. I love that. I feel like, honestly, the time I've got to spend with my family too has increased, which is crazy because it's like you would think that, like, I don't live with my family, so you would think that we don't get that time, but now we're like, oh, family night every, like, Sunday, which is against social distancing rules, but mind your business.
Everybody stays every other seat away from each other.
That's seriously. So, like, the time I get to spend with my family is crazy, and I love that. I love that I get to have that. And then I got back to writing. So me and P went to Target, and we went to Target for T-shirts, I think. We went to Target for T-shirts. And we got journals and pens and I think I spent $90 something at Target, and I was just supposed to get a $20 t-shirt, but that's none of your business. But it got me back to writing, and it got me back to, like, feeling my emotions and really, like, processing them, and that has been so good for me. What about you?
Definitely the time with Rodney. I loved it, but honestly, since Rodney's been born, I've only worked 6 months. So I've been blessed in that situation. Yeah. But right before Corona, I was working overnights. So, with working overnights, I would work from 10 o'clock to 7 o'clock in the morning. Then in order for me to sleep, I had to drop Rodney off at daycare and then get him and only spend maybe like 3 hours with him. And then, you know what I mean? So getting him and spending more time with him has helped not only me, but Rodney's development alone.
For real.
Like, before That's Corona, I'm trying to tell you, he did not speak.
Yeah.
Rodney did not speak. Like, he was mute, and they kept telling me really that he wasn't going to speak. Now he knows all his letters, A through Z, his numbers 1 through 10, shapes, instruments, like, if he sees, like, all types of stuff.
And not even to cut you off, but I remember before, like, this happened, Rodney went to, like, a session, and they were telling you, like, he's not ready to, like, go to school, and how that, like, really messed with you. And now it's like, oh, Rodney going to school,
man, get his backpack one way or ready. Another I'm trying to tell you, because that definitely broke my heart, like, and it was a situation of them saying if he can go to public schools or if he has to go to a autism school. And in the beginning, before all of this, I was like, I want him to go to a public school because I want him to feel normal, and I don't want him blah, blah, blah. And this is all being in my head because I only really have me to really kind of understand how I feel.
Yeah.
So, and, you know, people would tell you, oh, it's okay, Rodney is excellent, he excels. And I'm like, you guys almost, like, low-key, like, not have to say this, but of course you're going
you
to say
like
this.
You have to.
Right. Yeah. So, when they had said, like, most likely he's probably not going to go to a public school, I was just heartbroken. So literally, I think it was like maybe a week after that is when everything was shutting down, and I was like, psh, I got writing like pre-K books, 100 first words, like all this shit, and like every day I'm like, so that's one thing that's a major thing that has been amazing for me. Also getting back to journaling, writing. I love writing poetry. I might suck, but I feel like I'm great. And I feel like
great sis.
And like with all these things going on, not with just the world, but within my family, there's a lot of things going on within my family that has now been able to have me really kind of connect again, because I was very disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
And the first, like, 2 years of Rodney's life, it was me or Rodney against the world.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I didn't care about anything and anybody else. And now I'm finally getting to a point where, you know, I'm
Stella got her groove back, you know, pretty much. Pretty much.
So, yeah, that and just, you know, making business plans for myself. A lot of you may or may not know, I'm in a lot of different stuff. So I make soaps, I do hair, I do eyelashes. You know, I'm literally, like, in a lot of different things. And this time has really allowed me to make business plans for myself and, you know, set goals for myself on how much money I'm going to make here or how much product am I going to make here, how many eyelashes or how many heads I'm going to do here so that I can provide not only for myself but for my son and be in a better position and hopefully not have to work for anybody else ever again.
Because that's the goal, right? That is the goal. So do you feel like this has been like a blessing in disguise for you?
Not even in disguise because of the world situation.
Yes, because how the world views it. Yes.
And, you know, in this time, like, I lost an uncle from the coronavirus, so that was actually really, really difficult. I believe in my heart, before it became bigger in January, me and Rodney were extremely sick, like, for, like, a month and a half, so I really do feel like at some point I had it. I was, like I said, extremely sick, didn't smell anything, didn't taste anything, but eventually I was feeling better, but still couldn't smell or taste anything, and with everything going on, I'm like, I don't freaking know. So yeah. I was definitely at home. I was staying at home. But with that being said, yes, walking outside was like, oh my God. Like, it even looked crazy outside.
Yeah.
But when I was in my home, I'm like, I just feel blessed. I feel humbled. I feel like this is what not only I needed, but what Rodney needed.
Yeah, I would definitely say the same thing. Like, when you're in the moment and you see how the world is reacting to everything and you see that there's deaths and you see that people are like, oh, my family member got corona and, like, I don't know what my family's going to do. We can't be in the hospital with them. It's like, dang, all these good things are happening to me. And you kind of feel, at least for me, like, bad that you're like, I'm sorry this is happening to y'all, but my life right now is kind of peaking. Like, even though there's moments and situations where it's like, dang, this is kind of been like a detour in my life. It's still like, okay, I needed this time. Yeah. Like, this was set up for me. And it's like, yes, I know you guys are feeling some way right now, but I feel like this is exactly what I needed.
What I needed, for sure.
But then you feel bad for feeling that way because then...
Honestly?
I feel bad for feeling that way.
I'm going to tell you why I didn't feel bad. I didn't feel bad because it wasn't like I was flaunting in a way like, oh, corona's going on and I'm happy as hell. Like, no, but I definitely, like, for instance, yeah, everybody, you know, this is going on, but when Rodney first said his first ABCs or whatever, yes, I'm posting that, and it's giving people light. It's giving people something to smile about. That's just my happiness. And I get a lot of people that are like, I love watching you and Rodney's videos. They make me happy. They make me smile. And that's just me sharing my happiness.
Yeah.
So I didn't feel bad in that aspect because I feel like my happiness was definitely making other people happy. Mm-hmm. But I also wasn't like gloating like, oh, y'all stressed out? Well, I'm happy. I'm chilling.
Damn, that kind of makes me think, like, for me, individually at least, when you see that the world may be like hurting or grieving, like even when it comes to like what we're currently dealing with George Floyd, like when you see when the world is hurting, do you automatically feel like, oh, I have to hurt too? Like, I have to be upset because the world is upset. I don't personally feel that way. But when it comes to this, I feel like there are some certain things that I would have posted that I would have been like, dang, y'all, this is just happened for me and my family. Like, this is a come up. This is a blessing. Mm-hmm. And I don't post it because I feel like, well, there's people right now who are struggling, and then I'm posting this, and it's like, well, F you type thing, but then it's also the same where it's like, you're posting, and it's giving people happiness and light, so then am I taking away, like, someone's happiness by not posting? Like, they say you should express your blessings, like, you should always tell people about your, you know, your downfalls and your come-ups, but it's like, When people are hurting, do you still do that?
Honestly, me personally, I still go on with my day-to-day life. Mm. I cannot stop my life for anybody else and what they have going on. Now, am I going to be like, you know, just be like oblivious to everything that's going on? No, but I'm also not one, and a lot of people disagree with this, that I'm not speaking on a lot of what's going on for multiple different reasons. But I just feel like if I am in a position in my life where I am happy and I feel successful or whatever, I'm not going to take away my happiness and my energy because everybody else is not, happy. Now, do I feel for you? Do I yearn for you? Do I pray for you? Absolutely. Yeah. But I'm not going to be like, damn, the world is sad. Fuck.
I'm sad.
Absolutely not. No, there's a lot of great things that is going on in my life right now.
Yeah.
Despite the crazy shit that's going on in the world, and I'm still living for my life. I have to.
And I think, so I'm the type where it's like, yes, I will express, like, when things are going good for me, and I'll even express when things like are kind of shitty for me in that moment. But at the same time, I'm very in tune with like other people's emotions and their, because at like, if you know me, you know, I'm an emotional being. Like a lot of like what I do is kind of centered off of emotions, which is not good. And it's something that I've realized, especially during this time, and that I'm working on. But for me, it's like, oh, did I just hurt their feelings? Like, I don't want to make them sad. Yeah. I don't like, and it just, I don't know. I don't.
See, but I am like that, but to things that are happening like within my physical life.
Yeah.
So I can be very passive to a certain extent. But yeah, when it comes to like things in my life, I know that I can be really passive because I have a hard time with offending people and hurting people's feelings.
Mm.
That is one thing I absolutely hate. And I hate that I am like that because I don't speak exactly how I feel.
Yeah.
So, for instance, if somebody, like, if someone in my family, like, wants me to do something, it is so hard for me to say no.
Really?
It is extremely hard for me. So I end up finding myself doing 100 different things in one day. And at the end of the day, like, I'm so tired. And I get upset because I'd be like, dang, nobody, like, is offering to do anything for me. And knowing that, you know, I'm a struggling single mom, or nobody is calling to be like, oh, besides you, I won't say nobody because you do this for me. But calling me like, hey, how are you and Rodney? Yeah. Does Rodney need anything? Do you need anything? I don't get that. But I'm the first to be like, hey, I am out. Do you need this? So it definitely hurts. But at the same time, I still continue to allow it to happen.
Yeah.
And that's just only with family. Now, if it's somebody, just, I don't care about.
So where it's like, for me, it's like, no, I don't want to post this because I don't want to hurt their feelings. You're like, my happiness is my happiness when it comes to people who aren't directly in your life.
Right.
That's interesting.
Or like, for example, how I used to be. So like, if I was ever talking, like, let's say I was talking to someone.
Yeah.
And we stopped talking, but then, like, even, like, later on, I ended up, like, getting in a relationship or something. I am so terrified to be, like, to like, post or whatever, because I'm like, I don't want to hurt their feelings. But see, now I'm like,
see, oh. I'm petty, so I'm like, I'm going to post, and then I'm going to share my post. So you have to see it. It's going to be there twice. You're going to run into it at some point.
No, I feel like, at so, like, I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings, and, you know, I know we haven't talked in 4 months, but, you know, whatever. And then,
that's so weird, because I'm like, when it comes to people in my personal life, I don't really worry about hurting their feelings. Like, I feel like, and maybe this is bad, but I feel like, because you know me, because you know I love you, you should know my intentions are pure, you know I'm not trying to hurt your feelings.
Yeah.
So if I'm telling you something, or if I'm saying no to something, or if I'm expressing myself in some way, then you should know that it's out of genuine love and care. Unless I'm trying to hurt your feelings, then you know I'm trying to hurt your feelings. But when it comes to people I don't know, it's like, no, I don't want them to think I'm mean and rude. Like, I'll filter what I say more when it comes to things like that, because it's like, I don't want them to think that they don't know me. Like, they don't know my intentions. So
we're so opposite there.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, family, I'm like, I'm sorry. Like, unless, so I kind of take that back just a little bit. If it's like my sister,
yeah.
Well, even then, because like my little brother and sister, I would literally like put my account in the negative for them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, later on, like, fuck, okay. Mm-hmm. So how am I going to get this for my house when they probably didn't even actually need the things that, yeah. you know, whatever. But like, if it's just some random person, obviously, I'm just kind of like,
fuck it.
I really can care less. So, I can care less.
Yeah.
I can care less. But I just hate hurting people that... And it makes me mad, too, because people don't even give a fuck to hurt me or
no,
not.
No, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, people will be so quick to just do whatever they want, or let's just talk about social media, post whatever they want, and I'll be looking like... Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But they've done that, and I'm like... Well, I don't know if I should post this yet because what if they feel a certain type of way and I don't want to hurt their feelings? Like, and I'd be thinking to myself, like, what? But I just hate hurting people's feelings
because
in general.
Your intentions are pure. You have a pure heart, and do you think that's all?
Yes, but honey, I need to know when to turn that off.
Yeah.
And I have not mastered that yet. I am just so, like, or even just things that I do for people. When I say I go beyond,
yeah,
it's to a point where like I'm like I'll be telling myself in that process, Paradise, cut it out, and I have to, and I'll try to ask myself, would they do that for you? But then I really don't care. Like,
and
I'm really like
I've gotten to a point, because we've talked about this before, me and you are so alike in that sense. Well, we were like go to the ends of the earth if we have to make sure that the people that we love and care know that we love and
yes.
we care about them and are happy. And then we're thinking like, but would they do that for me? Mm-hmm. And I've gotten to the point where it's like, dang, are my intentions really pure if I think like that? Like, if I have that thought in the back of my head of like, if I was going through this, would they do that for me? Mm-hmm. Am I doing it because I really love and care about you? Or is there somewhat a sense of, I'm doing this for you because I hope that you would do it for me?
But I think eventually, after so many times of you doing the same thing, that question automatically just comes to your mind. Because, so when I go into a situation and I'm doing something for people, I don't expect anything back.
Yeah.
I don't even think about myself. I'm just thinking about, ooh, this will make them happy. This will make them sad, blah, 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 blah. Like, but I do it to the point where I'm like, okay, bruh, like, you
yeah.
did, like, all these different things. And then eventually, like, later down the line, I'll be getting up to number 7 of things out of the just craziness. And I'm like, I don't even think this person checks up on me.
So then it's a level of, like, appreciation.
Yeah.
Of, like, I can do all this stuff for you, and I expect nothing back
nothing
from
back.
You.
Nothing back.
But appreciation.
Yes.
And how you show your appreciation... Mm-hmm. Typically is like by making sure that they know that you care about
yes.
them and you love them. So it's kind of reciprocated. I don't know. I was getting to a point where I was like, dang, I need to check my intentions because are my intentions really pure? Because I'm thinking like, dang, would they actually do this for me if I was, or I think I got to that point where it's like, I would stop myself from doing something
mm-hmm.
because the thought of, would they do this for me?
See,
like,
but
I wouldn't actually
haven't gotten
go,
to the stop.
Yeah, I wouldn't actually go through with it. Like, I would be setting it up,
mm-hmm.
and then I'm like, F that, I'm not doing this, because they probably would not do that for me. And that's when I was like, oh, maybe I should check my intentions about that.
See, and I haven't gotten to the stop. I will think about those things and continue to do it, and then afterwards be like, you're dumb.
I wonder,
like, why did you do that? But that's
is more damaging.
Yeah, but honestly, it's one of my love languages.
Yeah.
It's gift giving and showing people appreciation and love and reassurance. That is how I express my love
mm-hmm.
to people. And like, I can't, if I really care for you, I can't just sit back and just be like, I love you.
Yeah.
I care for you. I'll see you later.
So is that the same way that you... That's the love language that you express. But is that the love language that you like to get back?
No, I don't care about
gifts.
My thing is this. Like, gifts are amazing when they are truly, like, spontaneous and special. And, you know, I really... Though it has to be, I can't know that you're trying to give me a gift.
Yeah.
If I know that, then I'm feeling a certain type. Like, I'm like, no, don't do that. Don't give
weird.
Me anything. I know. It's crazy. I'm fucking nuts. It is crazy. So, like, if you're like, I want to get you something. No. No. Because then, this is how my mind is so fucked up. the moment that I think someone's getting me something, I feel like they are going to eventually, when they get mad, throw it in my face. I don't want I don't want to have anybody have the opportunity to throw anything in my face. That's how I'll give all the gifts. I'll do all the gift giving. Just tell me you appreciate it and maybe write me, shout me out on Facebook.
So what is your love language that you like to receive? That's crazy. First of all, this is crazy because I've never even thought about the fact that, like, people could have different love languages that they express
but receive differently.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Receiving, for sure, words of affirmation.
Okay.
I, like, reassurance for me is everything. Mm. So it can be, like, honestly, I think, like, a shout out and, like, just a appreciation post or whatever is so much bigger to me than being like, here, I got you these $500 shoes that I'm probably not going to wear.
Yeah.
You know, or wear for one event or whatever. But you expressing literally, like, how you feel about me, the love that you have for me, the appreciation. I'm like...
So then do you, when you get in any new relationship, whether, like, friendship or, you know, romantic relationship, do you express... that you have different love languages, like, that you have different love languages that you like to, like, give to people and then that you like to receive? Because people would think, because Paradise goes all out for people, people would think, oh, her love language is gifts because she likes to give people gifts.
I can see that.
And so do you express to people, like, no, that's not actually my love language. I just like to do... weird.
I don't think I've ever had.
It's weird because then it's like, well, what if that's not that person's love language and you're giving them gifts and it's like, I don't need this.
Yes.
But that's like how you like to give love.
So I honestly have never truly expressed it.
Hmm.
I think I have had miniature conversations about it and we have had conversations like, do you like gifts? And I'm like, they cool. You know, whatever. But then I'm like, I got some plan. You know what I mean? So I think I've more made it an assumption than actually saying this is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And so I have to kind of, and I do that a lot. I need to personally learn how to communicate in a lot of different ways of how I feel.
Yeah.
Because I expect people to be like, well, why?
Oh, I know how she's feeling.
Yes. I'm a woman, I guess, in that aspect. Pause. Shut up, Paige. But... like, I really, like I said, gifts in me, like, gifts are sweet. Yes. Yeah. I'm not saying that I just absolutely don't like gifts because that's not true.
Right.
But do they fill my spirit? Do they, you know, do something here? No. It's more of a, like for example, today, me and Zay went to go get some food. And then we're going home.
Pause for the cause, y'all. There's a Zay.
Okay, keep going.
Stella got her group back.
We went to go get some food. And, like, we are just driving back home. He's like, oh, I gotta go to Walmart. And I'm like, okay. But we're at my house, so I was kind of confused. He's like, oh, you need mouthwash. You need trash bags. And I'm like...
that's manly. You better make sure the house is good.
So that right there, that is like... okay,
but you I don't think that's gifts.
That's what I'm saying. That's not gifts. That's literally like reassuring me that you're paying attention to not only like me, but you know, things that are important to me that I mean, maybe around my house. I mean, you're here, but you're showing that you actually care further than
that's dope.
So things like that make my heart smile. But being like, hey, I got you this gift. Like I'm like. Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.
And I'm probably not going to.
That's crazy. I think, so I know we are so off topic, y'all, but it's okay. We're flowing. But for me, I think I've always said, like, my love language was words of affirmation, physical touch, and there was another one that I forgot. And I've always felt like gifts was, like, low-key.
Mine used to be physical touch until you're, like, right here.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
back up.
I can't breathe.
So words of affirmation and physical touch are definitely like my top two.
Mm-hmm.
But I used to always feel like undercover, like I kind of think gifts is one of mine
too. You can have multiple.
But I didn't want to seem like materialistic.
Mm-mm.
I felt like saying like gifts is a love language of mine is like, oh, she's just materialistic, so I gotta buy her shit to make her happy. And it's like, no, that's not it. I just like to be, I like the surprise of it. Yes. I like the, like, and it doesn't even have to be a radical gift, like a MK bag or anything like that. It could just be something like, babe, I was coming home from work and I stopped at King Supers and they have 100-gram bars. And I know 100-gram bars is your favorite candy and they never have them, or they didn't have them last time. Here you go. It's like, oh, that just makes me so happy. And that's how I view it as a gift. But, like, I always felt like if I verbally, like, admitted that to someone, it would be like, oh, she's materialistic.
I don't think. Because if you take the test, it'll rank how much one is of the other. So have you ever taken the test?
Yeah, okay, yeah, so
my gifts, like receiving gifts, were last, and it was like a 2.
Really?
Yeah. So, but that doesn't mean I don't like to receive gifts.
See, and maybe I should retake the test, because I feel like maybe I lied on the test, because I didn't want gifts to be up there. I'm like, if gifts is up there and I tell him that.
But I think within this time that like I said, which, like we had started out, within this time of Corona and everything going on, it has made you sit and really think about, what is it that I want in general?
Yeah.
What is it that I like to receive, or what is my love language? Yeah. What isn't? Because it could have changed from what it was 3 months ago. And now we're sitting around and thinking about the things that we really love and we really want. That could be a completely different thing, scale from what it,
what's been. That makes a lot exactly. of sense. That makes sense.
I think, like I said, I personally take the tests multiple times a year, and it always changes, except for words of affirmation. It's always on my top. But it always changes.
Yeah.
So, but like I said, during this time, it really made me sit down and really kind of think, what is it specifically that I want moving forward? I have all the time in the world right now to think about it.
Yeah.
What is it that I want? And that
makes sense, because maybe it's just like this point in my life right now, like with everything going on, a gift here and there is like
special
with like the world is shut down and you got me a gift. Like,
exactly. You might not be working as much, but you spent money.
You found a way to give me a gift. Like, so it may be because of everything, but.
Which is fine. Which is fine. And I think change is shown, not a shown, what am I trying to say? Is a different vision of growth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I feel like if you had the same of anything that's going on, you're not really showing that you're growing.
No, you're growing.
So during this time, you might say, gifts make me feel a certain type of way, because right during this time, you're feeling, you're changing, you know, differently.
Yeah.
But in 3 months, when everything is hectic again, you might be like, physical touch, I just want a foot rub after a long day of work. That is what I need.
That makes sense. Like, that's even a good...
I'm gonna get there, though, because
we're gonna get there.
Even last night, me and Jazz were texting. And
I was like, my friend is upset.
Man. And we were actually talking about what we were gonna talk about today. And when I was in pain, y'all, I'm going through some things right now, and I was in pain, and Jazz is sending me, like, you know, a book.
My mind was going.
Of what she wants to talk about. And in my mind, I'm really reading it, like, but I'm kind of skimming, and I'm just like, that's fine, boo. And I go back this morning, and I'm looking, and I'm seeing that she's sending me
I know her, so I'm like, are you sure? How do you really feel? And then she tells me, and then I respond back to that, and she's like, that's fine. And I'm like, okay, we're just going to leave this here.
Instead, but then this morning I texted her and I'm like, boo, I'm so sorry. Last night I was in pain, blah, blah, blah. And so she's like, well, next time just tell me. Yeah. Like, and I'm like, but I didn't know how. Like, I was hurting.
No, but that's good. I don't know. We're growing and we're learning and we're evolving. And I think different things like this is... sometimes it's what we need, regardless if you realize it or not, if you're really struggling during this time or not. Like, I think for all of us as a collective people, it's going to end up being beneficial. Yeah, it has to be somehow.
And finding a good support system within this time, because a lot of people are going through depression and anxiety and, you know, a lot of hurt, suicide, all types, because they're going crazy, even domestic violence, because people are now stuck at home with their kids. They're usually at school and they're probably driving. People probably have 5 freaking kids at home at one time, and they might all be getting, you know what I mean? There's so many things that might be going on. So to find a good support system within this time, I think is probably one of the most important things that we can do when it comes to evolving and when it comes to making changes. I know I personally, this is the first time in my life that I feel like I have a somewhat okay support system. Mm-hmm. Before, like, I felt alone a lot of the times, and I was figuring a lot of stuff out on my own. So now that I have a support system and I'm figuring out a way to actually communicate, I can actually vocalize how I feel, rather than before when I didn't know, I'm depressed as hell in the bathroom crying and figuring out, am I worth tomorrow?
Yeah.
So we moved to the couch because the couch is our healing area. Mm-hmm. And so for me, that conversation just really helped me. One, first of all, it was different than I even thought we were going to have.
Definitely.
But it just helped me realize, like, that as I grow and evolve, it's okay for things that I need to change. It's okay for things that I no longer desire to change, and just to process that and communicate that and really take that time within myself to figure it out. Because if I don't take that time to figure it out within me, then I can't communicate it.
I like that. For me, it was, it healed me in areas because I was able to, when speaking on something, I finally realized, like, it's like a light bulb goes mm-hmm. in my head. I could be thinking these things and not know what's going on. So for example, when you said you can have a different love language that you receive and you give. And I'm like, I'm speaking it, but never thought about it that way.
So crazy.
So for me, you know, with moving forward and not only my relationship with my friends, my son, my significant other, whatever, I am able to vocalize exactly how I feel and exactly what I need and what I am receiving, and if that person needs the same thing. Because you can be so, you can do what you want all day for a person. You can, you know, give a person gifts or whatever, but for someone like me, okay, it doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
And again, I didn't really realize that until we just had this conversation. Yeah. So figuring out different ways to communicate is really one thing that I am focusing on right now. And I think this conversation definitely opened a door for the next conversation I'm able to have when trying to figure out someone's or my love language.
This is good, y'all. This was a good season 2, episode 1 video. There has been changes, as you can see. So again, Healing Couch, YouTube, and Basic Media. Love y'all.
And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on both Basic Media and the Healing Couch's YouTube.